Most people want to be rich, but they don't know what it's like to take the steps, what hard work, what routine and schedules to follow, and what mindset to have. Wealthy people employ vision boards. It's not about what rich people do, it's what about they don't do. Rich people know where to invest the money, while the poor people use money to consume more goods and services. Find out your aspirational R&D rate. The more the value, the more your earnings. Rich people have a vision, not just for 5 years, but for 10 years and 15 years. Self-made millionaire Steve Seibold spent 26 years of his life interviewing some of the wealthiest people in the world, and this is what he had to say after his study. The masses always think that the wealthy people are smarter, luckier, and more educated. But none of that is true. The mindset rules and the habits of the rich that I'm going to share in this video are some of those that I have used to get more than 100% hike from my previous employers, to crack interviews at Fortune 500 companies, to start my own company, and to become a public speaker. And some of them are those which I have read and I have researched. So let's begin with the first one. The first one is, rich people use money to make more money for them. Do you know that around 70% of lottery winners go bankrupt within the first 5 years, irrespective of whether they have earned 1 million or 500 million? That's because when they earn so much amount of money, they don't know what to do with it. They start spending carelessly on goods and services that they don't need. Wealthy and rich people know where to invest the money. They use the money to make more money, while the poor people use money to consume more goods and services. Well, if you have been able to relate to the video till now, and if you know that money is capable of making more money for you, then do consider subscribing and stay till the end of the video. Let's see the second point, which is becoming more valuable, not just for your own self, but also for the world. See, the world only compensates one for the value that it brings onto the table. If you're not earning enough, then you need to ask yourself, how much value are you offering to others? If your business is not earning enough, or if you're not scaling, then you need to understand how much of value you're offering to your clients. If you're not getting promoted after 2 years, then how much of value are you offering to your workplace? Maybe that value needs to go up. The more the value, the more you're earning. It's as simple as that. Here are two things to keep in mind. Firstly, your current skill set. If your current skill set could be utilized more and more value could be offered to the world. The second is acquiring more skills, so you become automatically more valuable to the world. And when you acquire more skills and you become more valuable, then you gain conviction and confidence. And this brings me to my third point, which is, rich people are very confident and are very strong in their conviction. You know, last year I went to a seminar and I was hearing a speaker who I really liked. So without thinking even for a bit, I went to the speaker and plainly asked him, how much did you charge for that speaking session? And the speaker replied, $40,000. Woof, it just blew my mind. But with the conviction that he spoke, the confidence that he had, the personality which he radiated, made me realize that he totally deserved it. So people always earn and get what they know they deserve, what they feel they deserve. You have to feel and you have to believe strongly that what you deserve is not enough and that you want more. Rich people believe that anything and everything is possible in the world. They feel that they have a right to be rich because they know that the value that they're offering to the world is huge. Rich people are not bound by limited beliefs and thoughts. Find out your aspirational hourly rate. First, understand what is your current hourly rate, like your total salary, your total income divided by the total number of working hours. And then see, what is your aspirational hourly rate, and do whatever it takes to match that difference. Fourth is, millionaires are crazy people. They are unusual people. They are not ordinary. They don't do anything which is ordinary. They're like mad scientists. They run after something and they know that it's gonna work like a mad person. Even if it doesn't work, that passion to run after something gives them the kick in life. They are in their own world all the time. They don't agree to 99% of the things in this world. See, understand that this is a cluttered world. If you want to be recognized, if you want to be heard, if you want someone's attention on you, you have to do something different. You have to behave differently. You have to act differently. You have to not be normal. You have to be weird. You have to be cool. Rich people know that it's not just about education, because education will give you the tool to get a job in the industry. But they know that they have to go beyond that. And for that, they have to be more productive. They have to have the correct mindset. They have to have the habits and the routines and the schedules in place. The fifth is taking action. Suppose if I have an idea to make a different type of a fighter jet, then that fighter jet will just remain a dream in my mind because I'm not taking any action towards it. That fighter jet will come into action when I take action. If I take steps to build it, or if I take the steps to get it built from someone else to start implementing that idea, then only it'll look like a live object. Otherwise, it's just in my mind, it's just in my dream. So rich people don't just have ideas, they also have plans to execute this. And there is always a risk factor attached. If you look at Warren Buffett, he always has a risk factor attached to when he's investing in different stocks. He has a lower cap, but he also has an upper cap, and there is risk attached at all the levels. Another thing to understand is rich people are accountable to their own self much more than they are accountable to anyone. They don't need a boss sitting on top of their head and asking if this work is done or not done. They are accountable to their own self. They are happy and content when they know that they have worked the entire day so they can sleep peacefully. They promise it to themselves that their idea is going to go to execution, and that is more than enough for them. But taking action is not possible if your physical and your mental health is not supporting you. And that brings me to my sixth point, which is rich people understand that health is wealth. If your physical health and if your mental health is not performing at an optimum capacity, no matter whatever ideas you have, you will never have the capacity to execute them. For example, Jeff Bezos, he ensures 8 hours of sleep every night to stay sharp at decision making. And they just don't invest in gyms, they also invest in nutritionists. They invest in ergonomic office furniture. They invest in tailoring their fitness to their body. They invest in diet plans. Furthermore, they also have regular health checkups to understand their mental health with a psychologist or a counselor. They have regular sessions with counselors and mental health therapists. This holistic approach to health ensures that they stay at the top of their game. Rich people say a yes to a lot of things in life, but it's more important to understand that they're also saying a no, and they're saying more often than they're saying a yes. Because when you say a no, you are saying yes to the more important things in your life. It's not about what rich people do, it's what about they don't do. If they don't want to finish a book, they say a no to it. If they don't want to meet someone, if they don't want to attend a party, if they don't want to eat junk food, they simply say a no. Because when you say a no, you create space for yes, for something that is high priority. Saying a no is a crucial aspect for setting boundaries, for communicating our needs and wants, and maintaining our emotional and mental well-being. The eighth point is rich people have a vision. A vision not just for 5 years, but for 10 years and 15 years. For this, I would recommend maintaining a SWOT analysis for yourself. So prepare 4 quadrants, strength, weakness, opportunities, and threats. And based upon your strengths and weaknesses, see what opportunities and threats lie ahead. And then when you analyze those, see where you see yourself in the next 5 years. If you're starting a company, see yourself how you want to grow in the next 5 years, how much you want to scale, how much money you want to raise, how many people you want to hire, in which market segment you want to focus more. And I know the market keeps changing and you have to keep adapting to it. But a rough vision for the next 5, 10, 15 years is extremely important. For example, Elon Musk's roadmap for SpaceX spans decades and not just a couple of years. This disciplined planning of the rich drives them relentlessly towards their aspiration. So if you don't know what your destination is, if you don't know where you want to go, then how will you? If you don't know what path to take, then you might be taking any path. You might be just going haywire. So knowing your destination, where you want to go, where you want to see yourself in the next 5 years, is important to carve out a path which would work out for you. The second last is visualization. It is said that if you can visualize in your mind and visualize clearly, see it clearly happening, then that mental state can easily become the reality of your life. It becomes a tangible physical state of your life. The rich people visualize, rehearse their goals, creating a detailed image of success. Wealthy people employ vision boards. For example, if you want to see yourself in a skinny body in the next 6 months, then carve out a picture, print it out, put it on the vision board, and see yourself in that skinny body. If you can see yourself clearly walking on a beach in a skinny body, and if you can convince your mind that you can have it, then you can really have it. And you will make it a reality if you can see it in your mind. This mental preparation aligns their actions with their dreams, helping them seize opportunities and overcome obstacles. Visualization turns abstract goals into tangible reality, driving relentless pursuit. And all the 9 points that I have mentioned is not possible if you are available all the time for other people in your life. And that brings me to my 10th point, which is rich people are hard to reach. Because if you're saying yes to everyone in your life, if you're easily available for everyone, then you're letting everyone steal your energy and your mental bandwidth, which you have to preserve because that is limited. Your energy is limited. Your time is limited. Rich people go off the grid and they're unreachable via phone or email. If they're doing something which is very important, if they're in a deep work, then they have automated reply messages on their email, which makes other people know that they are not available. So when they will be available, they will find time, they will reply back. And this is how they work. It's not like they have to explain about this to someone. Everyone around them knows that this is how they operate. The advantage of the schedule is that you get extended periods of undivided attention. People who are always available for others end up feeling tired, end up feeling exhausted mentally. So the same way as we preserve our phone's batteries for something which is more important, like an important call, we similarly have to preserve our own human body's batteries if we have to do something more important in life, if we have higher priorities than to always be available for other people. And I hope you like the contents of this video. Please do share in the comment section. I've also prepared another video on what to do if you're in your 20s and 30s. So I'll see you on the other side if you want to watch that video.